from the shining domicile that is Pittsburgh Comics, my old Maynard comic shop owner, Colin McMahon, transforms into the world's greatest comic book talking TV host. Join us true believers for Comics Now!
Hey everybody, welcome to Comics Now for December 2020. We've almost made it through the year, and what a year it's been. Just a little warning, if you hear a little click-clacking, we're filming with the dogs here, because normally I come in early Monday morning and we do this and I leave the dogs at home. But they're here today, so if you hear any little click-clacking, that's them walking around. But we've made it to the end of the year, and it's going out with a bang. Lots of really good stuff going on. Some stuff going on here at the store. It's still hard. I'm not sure, you know, what we can do as far as events and things like that. So no Christmas parties or anything. But we're still going to have lots of neat stuff going on. We're going to do the 12 days of Festivus, like we always do. The 12 days leading up to Christmas. I'll be doing a different little sale or promotion each day. Just a little. Nothing super exciting, but one day it'll be, you know, Marvel graphic novels, another day it'll be action figures, different things for different days. A little different this year only because with my help situation, I'm closed on Mondays, so there's going to be 2 days where there's nothing going on because I'm closed. So, but check the website, check Facebook, check Twitter, because I'll be posting what's going on each day on those sites, so if you're interested. So, on to the comics. Now, lots of stuff going on from, I don't want to say all the companies, but definitely Marvel and DC have a lot of neat stuff going on. So, we'll start with Marvel. And the big thing Marvel has going on is King in Black. This is their big Venom story, where the creator of all the symbiotes that Venom is now coming to Earth to take over. And so, all the Marvel heroes are getting involved. They have to stop this giant invasion. He's bringing these big symbiote dragons and lots of stuff going on. So starting off, we have King in Black number 1 and 2 are both coming out in December. So big books, exciting. Come give a look. Venom 31 is tying in, of course, because if Venom wasn't tying in, it wouldn't make sense. But it's Eddie Brock taking on Null. They're doing a symbiote Spider-Man book, the King in Black book. This was the story of when Peter was still wearing the black costume back in the 80s, and they're kind of telling a retro tale. And in this one, it's where he runs into, not Null, not the big bad guy, but one of his minions who comes down. He's like, hey, buddy, and then they start fighting, and the guy's all confused because he's supposedly one of the symbiotes. Black Cat is getting relaunched with a new number one. And this one, Null's attack spoils one of Black Cat's planned robberies, and that really makes her mad. So she and her team are now going to try to mess him up and steal something that is very important to him and his ability to attack Earth. King in Black, Iron Man, Doctor Doom. So you're bringing in these two frenemies, and they have to get together and take on... basically, Null has taken over Santa Claus in the reindeers, and they've now become symbiotes. So Iron Man and Dr. Doom are going to have to try to stop Santa Claus. So sorry if it ruins Christmas for everybody. King of Black, Immortal Hulk. Immortal Hulk has been going on a real dark horror type story, and it's now tying in where he's going to have to deal with the symbiotes are messing with his lifestyle and what's going on. King in Black, Namor. Now this is, it's interesting this is tying in. It sounds like a really neat story. Spinning out of King in Black epic comes a dark, chilling story of the birth of Atlantis' greatest villains. The players, Namor, Lady Dorma, and Atuma, are all still in their teen years. And the Swift Riders, the Atlantean Empire's greatest heroes, and they, what should be a joining and a happy celebration, is messed up with tragedy, betrayal, and unleashing deadly magics. So this is kind of an interesting story. I'm not quite sure how it ties in with the event, but it's kind of an early story of Namor and what set him on his path to hate all land people. So The Union is a new book. This is by Paul Grist. It's basically a group of British heroes coming together to fight Null. The interesting thing is this was supposed to be an Empire story that they then repurposed to King in Black. So it's kind of, it's like, oh, well, that's interesting. But the grand unveiling of the Union. A team of superheroes gathered from all of the United Kingdom, featuring Union Jack, Snakes, Kelpie, Quire, and their fearless leader, Britannia. But when Null and his dragons attack Earth, their fledgling team is immediately pushed to their limits. Spider-Woman is tying in. Under the cover of the Null invasion, Spider-Woman is stealing elements of a cure for her condition. Or is she? And then there's a Null Marvel Tales book, which is a big one of the big $8 reprint books, reprinting a bunch of issues of Venom, introducing Null, and giving you some more background on him. And they're also doing a King in Black handbook, which is going to explain all the players and give you a lot more depth into what all is involved. Now, some other books we have. MODOK Head Games. This is being written by the creators of the Marvel animated show that's going to be coming, which one of which is Patton Oswalt. MODOK is the ruthless and brilliant leader of the terrorist organization AIM, outsmarting heroes and outmaneuvering his cutthroat colleagues, gunning for his position. But when he begins to be haunted by memories of a family he never had, it leaves him unsure if he is losing his freakishly large mind, or if perhaps there's a lot more to his enormous mind. Sword is coming out. This is by Al Ewing. Now, one of the big parts of X of Swords was the 10th sword. Reading the whole thing, there were only 9 swords. It was very confusing. The last one was Sword, which is the Sentient World Observation Response Directorate. And they're basically designed to protect Earth from outside attacks. And it's a giant space station shaped like a sword. So that came into play in X of Swords. Well, now Sword is back. And this is the story of Sword kind of reforming to protect Earth. Heroes at Home, basically they're just having a little fun. And basically the heroes are stuck at home too. And what's going on and what are they doing during quarantine? And then we have a bunch of X of Swords Aftermath books. All the X books are continuing with the fallout of the end of X of Swords. So Cable 7 is reeling from the events of X of Swords. Cable turns back to the matter of missing mutant babies, something he knows a thing or two about. Hellions played a major role in X of Swords, and Mr. Sinister's teams of Hellions are dead. Oh the pain, oh the injustice, oh the... Wait a minute, what's Sinister really up to? X-Factor, number 5, the events of X of Swords have put the resurrection protocols in jeopardy. As the 5 deal with the fallout, X-Factor investigation has to deal with those affected by the tragedy of X of Swords. Wolverine number 8 is also 350, so it's a big oversized, you know, anniversary issue. Someone is making moves against Wolverine's old crew, Team X, and it's leaving bodies dropped and artifacts stolen. A mystery unfolds as Logan picks up the scent of his old compatriot, the mutant known as Maverick. New Mutants 14, on the edge of Krakoan society, the New Mutants are loose in the Wild Hunt. Going big, blowing things up, and combining powers to see who gets crowned King of the Mountain. But something lurks in the trees, something old and hungry, and its favorite prey is young mutants. X-Force 15, Omega Red harbors a deadly secret, and X-Force may have to cross a line to keep Krakoa safe. Excalibur 16, the team is left changed by the aftermath of X of Swords, and some things lost cannot be replaced. X-Men 16, the Captain Commander of Krakoa made a fateful decision. There's no going back. Marauder 16, the Black King did wrong. Now he must pay. They're also doing a celebration of Chris Claremont, who was the X-Men writer from, I want to say, the mid-70s until the 90s. So they're doing a celebration issue, letting him play with some of his favorite characters and ones that he created, and doing a special anniversary issue. Amazing Spider-Man is going to be wrapping up the Last Remains storyline. There's still issue 54, 54 LR, and 55 to this. Then there's a new X-Men book. It's a mini-series called Web of Spider-Man, but it's not just Web. It's WEB, which is the Worldwide Engineering Brigade. Basically, a new lab has been created by Tony Stark for young people to get into science and things, and Peter Parker has been invited, so we'll see what kind of hijinks will ensue. Ghost Rider is doing a special, The Return of Vengeance. They're bringing Vengeance back up from hell to cause havoc on Earth. Avengers 40 is starting a big storyline. This is Enter the Phoenix, and basically the Phoenix Force, this giant, powerful entity in the universe, is coming back to Earth to find a new host. So now the Avengers and some of the most powerful heroes and villains in the Marvel Universe are being called into a competition unlike anything they've ever seen. a globe-spanning battle that will transform them all and ultimately decide who will be the all-new Phoenix. Fantastic Four Road Trip, just a little one-shot, but Reed has planned an old-fashioned family vacation to the Grand Canyon. But Reed's manic mind can't quite disengage, and soon an obsessive side experiment he brought with him has all of them experiencing gruesome and terrifying side effects from his strange specimens. And then we're also getting King-Size Conan number one. It's the 50th anniversary of Conan, so we're getting a big giant size special with all sorts of fun stuff for Conan fans. So that's what Marvel has going on. Now on to DC. DC has some stuff going on still. Starting off, real big book that we've been waiting just about a year for is Batman Catwoman number one. At last, Tom King returns to the rocky romantic saga of Batman and Catwoman. Echoing plot points from King's epic Batman run, this sweeping tale is told across three timelines. The past, when the Bat and the Cat first fall in love. The present, where their union is threatened by one of Batman's lost loves. And the future, where the couple have a happy life and legacy, including their daughter, Helena. So that's gonna finally start. Batman Black and White. They did this years ago where they had top creators tell just short stories, and it's all done in black and white, giving the, you know, the mood and things to Batman. So that's back with another series. And then Endless Winter is their December event. It's all taking place just in December. An ancient evil has emerged from the Arctic wilderness, and only the combined might of the Justice League, the Teen Titans, and some other unexpected super beings can put a stop to it and save the world from becoming a permafrost nightmare. This is going through Justice League Endless Winter Special number one, Flash 767, Superman Endless Winter Special, Aquaman 66, Justice League 58, Teen Titans Special, Justice League Dark 29, Black Adam Special, and then Justice League Endless Winter 2. So just a big little self-contained event going through those books. Generation Shattered is a big one-shot. A threat of cosmic proportions to DC's newest and oldest universe compels one of the most unusual groups of heroes ever assembled to take on the most mysterious foes they have ever encountered. And now we get into all the Dark Knight stuff that's going on. We have Dark Knight's Death Metal, The Last Stories of the DC Universe, is another one-shot. The Last Battle Against the Batman Who Laughs is at hand. The final fight for everything in the universe. These are the stolen moments detailing the last stories of the DC Universe. We also have Dark Knight's Death Metal, The Secret Origin, which is the DCU's darkest secrets are expected or explored while two titans clash. The heroes search for a way to defeat the darkest night through the universe's past, while Superboy Prime faces down the iconic Batman. Then we have Death Metal, The Last 52, War of the Multiverses. What would it take to get everybody left in the multiverse to side together in the ultimate final showdown? Total decimation and the complete undoing of all existence. This epic battle book details every side of the last war across the multiverse. And then we have Dark Knight's Death Metal 6 and 7 are both coming out in December. And within number 7, it's Wonder Woman stands ready to take on the Darkest Knight solo. But the important part here is, plus this oversized finale includes two mind-blowing epilogues that will lead directly into the next phase of the DC Universe. So there's a chance that this could have a really big effect on everything DC has going forward. We won't know for a bit because January and February are future state books that I'll talk about next month. So we won't know what's going on with the regular DC Universe until March. So they're building up to something, I certainly hope. They're also doing a Christmas special, The Very Merry Multiverse, which they do every year. They do all the holiday specials. And then they're also doing a Ginny Hex special. This is Jonah Hex's great-great-granddaughter who was in the Young Justice book, and she's getting her own one-shot, which is going to tell a little bit more of her past story and give her a little solo adventure. Now, they're doing a bunch more of the Tales of the Dark Multiverse, where they take a story event that happened in the regular universe and kind of turn it on its head to give it a dark multiverse twist. So, Crisis on Infinite Earths. When the Anti-Monitor's deadly grudge match with the multiverse was finally foiled, there was only one Earth left. But which Earth was left? So, in our world, it was the Prime Earth. Somewhere else, it was a different one. Dark Knight's Metal, where the heroes got together and defeated Barbados in Dark Knight's Metal. What if they hadn't? What if they had lost? So that's that story. in War of the Gods, where Wonder Woman fought the gods who were trying to take over Earth. What if instead it was Wonder Woman trying to take over Earth and the gods trying to stop her? Then we also have Batman Annual number 5, which is the origin of Clown Hunter and giving his backstory and how he came to be. So that's it for the big two. Now we'll get on to the other guys. Starting off, Image. Image has a great team in Ed Brubaker and Sean Phillips, who are doing these great books, Criminal and some other books. Pulp was hugely well received. And they have a new one called Reckless, which is going to be a 3-book story. Meet Ethan Reckless. Your trouble is his business for the right price. But when a fugitive from his radical student days reaches out for help, Ethan must face the only thing he fears, his past. Post-Americana is another post-apocalyptic one, but basically the Cheyenne Mountain installation is the most sophisticated bunker in the world designed to house the government in the event of a disaster. Well, the government didn't make it there. Instead, high society did. And so they've been living in protection, and now one person in there has declared himself president and has decided to make all the other survivors of this apocalypse his underlings and crush them under his boot. So, and of course, there's going to be a rebellion, believe it or not. Homesick Pilots. I'm hearing lots of good things about this from people who have already read preview copies. But in the summer of 1994, a haunted house walks across California. Inside is Amy, lead singer of a high school punk band who's been missing for weeks. How did she get here, and what do these ghosts want? Dark Horse has a couple. They have a new Overwatch book based on the video game. Overwatch Tracer London Calling. Tracer's time as an Overwatch agent is up. She now tends to small-scale crimes as a part-time hero. But when a punk rock omnic named Iggy shows Tracer the dire living conditions that they have been forced on London's omnics, Tracer becomes determined to help. There's a Critical Role book, which has been really popular. They have Volume 3 coming out. And then Hellboy and the BPRD, Her Fatal Hour, which is... Hellboy took on the Beast of Vargu and it didn't go well, but he was helped by some Romani women and now they need his help, so he's returning to the scene of the disaster. IDW just has one big one. It's Transformers Escape coming out this month, where as Cybertron descends into a state of war, countless civilians are caught in the crossfire. Some of the Cybertron's greatest scientists seek to reactivate the ARC program and evacuate the planet. Dynamite has a couple new series starting. We have Vampirella, The Dark Powers. Welcome to the Project, an interdimensional collective of superheroes tasked with recruiting members from across infinite worlds. And their newest recruit is Vampirella. So she's going to try to be a superhero vampire. And then Red Sonja, The Price of Blood. Red Sonja faces the gallows. For all the blood she has spilled, there is a price. Boom has a big one. It's The Expanse number 1. Lots of fans of this book. Lots of fans shop here and are very excited about it. It's a new limited series that takes place between season 4 and season 5. So the description made no sense to me as I haven't watched it. But that's where this story fits in. They also have a new Jim Henson Labyrinth book, The Masquerade, that takes place at a ball. Aftershock has a couple new ones. We have Knock 'Em Dead. Dreyer Bryce has always wanted to be funny, and now he's taken the plunge and started doing stand-up comedy. Unfortunately, his older sister wants her brother to stop daydreaming and focus on his future. Pryor is determined to succeed. The only problem is he sucks at stand-up. That is, until an accident changes everything. Piecemeal is a one-shot by Colin Bunn. 5 high school kids, soon to say goodbye to each other and the lives they've known, enter the Nightmare House, the source of local legend and superstition. What they discover within the crumbling old house will fill them with terror. Ahoy is bringing back Second Coming. There's the Second Coming second series, Only Begotten Son. The infant Sunstar will grow up to fulfill his destiny as Earth's most powerful superhero. But first, he and his parents must endure the mundane and tedious events of the last night of the doomed planet Zirconia. AWA, which does the Upshot line, which has been really, really well received. You guys really love their stuff. Has a couple new ones. There's Erratic, number 1. You're 15 years old. You're suddenly granted incredible powers. Cool, right? There's only one problem. You can only use your powers for 10 minutes at a time. and bite-sized. When two young siblings excitedly unwrap their final Christmas presents, they discover toy robots unlike anything they have ever seen. What the kids and their parents don't know is that their quaint home just became the beachhead for these self-aware bots that have begun to explore the outside world. And lastly, we come to Vault, who's doing tons of really good books, really small. It's a small publisher, but they're doing a lot of really neat stuff. And they have a good horror book coming called The Picture of Everything Else. As the 20th century dawn, art promises to change the world and steep it in blood. A rash of impossible killings sweep through Paris, tearing the rich and beautiful apart in their beds. When two art thieves stumble upon portraits of the victims, damaged in the exact same manner they died, it appears the man who once painted the immortal painting of Dorian Gray has returned with darker plans for future works. So, a twisted Dorian Gray story. So, thanks for watching. This is the December show. This is a great time to be inside reading. You know, nobody's going out, nobody's doing things. So if you want to get somebody a gift, books are awesome right now. So if you have an idea, come in, give us a clue. We can try to find something for somebody on your list. As always, if you want to get a hold of me, contact me at the store. Facebook is Pittsburgh Comics. The website is pittsburghcomics.com. Twitter and Instagram are PGH Comics. So happy holidays. I hope everything's going well for you. And stay tuned for Comic Previews Theater. Thanks for watching. So Christmas time is here, and I was asked to read a Christmas story, so I couldn't find a better one than one with the DC superheroes. So we have DC's Christmas Heroes. So here we go. Christmas is coming. It's time for the holiday heroes to deck the Hall of Justice. They decorate the tree. They give a friend something sweet. Ooh, there we go. They find the perfect gift. And bring a bit of cheer to everyone. They even help Santa when he needs it. Holiday heroes spread goodwill and mistletoe. And they have lots of fun. They try not to be naughty. And most of all, holiday heroes make sure that everyone feels welcome. Merry Christmas and Happy Holidays. So happy holidays from me and the pups, and have a great holiday season and stay safe. See ya.